Hello. Alice fell down a rabbit hole one day and found herself in a wonderland where animals talk, curious things happen, and everything she eats and drinks makes her grow bigger or smaller. Now she is sitting alone. Suddenly, she heard footsteps. The white rabbit was running towards her. He seemed to be very worried.
Oh dear! Where can I have dropped them? I must find them, or I'm sure the Duchess will chop off my head!
Alice guessed he was looking for the gloves and fan that he had dropped, but she didn't know where they were either. After all her growing and shrinking, Alice was exactly the same size as the rabbit. When the white rabbit saw Alice, he spoke to her quite angrily.
Mary Ann, what are you doing out here? Run home this minute and get me a pair of gloves and a fan. Quickly!
How surprised he'll be when he finds out I'm not Mary Ann.
Alice began to run, as the white rabbit had told her, although she didn't quite know where she should run to. But soon, a little house appeared with the words W Rabbit written on the door.
I won't knock on the door. The real Mary Ann might hear me.
Alice crept into the house and went quietly upstairs to a little bedroom. And there she found two fans, three pairs of gloves and...
another bottle! I hope it makes me grow bigger again. I'm tired of being such a tiny little thing.
And sure enough, Alice began to grow. Taller and taller she grew until...
Ouch, my head! That's quite tall enough. That's tall enough! Oh! Oh!
Alice tried her hardest to stop growing, but it seemed to her like the harder she tried, the taller she grew. Soon, Alice was so big that she filled the whole room. Her head pressed up against the ceiling, her arm went out of the window, and one of her feet went up the chimney.
What will become of me now?
Outside the house, a crowd started to gather. Alice heard voices.
Oh my, whatever could it be?
What's that?
Soon, the white rabbit arrived.
What's that in the window?
It's an arm, sir.
An arm? Well, it's got no business being there. Bill? Bill, fetch the ladder and take it away.
Bill was the gardener. He brought a ladder and climbed up onto the roof.
I won't have an arm in my bedroom. Down you go, Bill. Down the chimney.
Poor Bill went up the ladder and tried to go down the chimney, but Alice's foot was waiting for him with a big kick.
Ow! Oh!
Quick, help him up.
Give him some air.
There, that's got rid of him. Now what will they try?
Yes, the cakes. Bring the cakes. We'll need a lot of them. That's right. Now, everybody, throw them through the other window.
What's this? Oh, lots and lots of little cakes. I wonder, if I ate them, would I shrink again? They must do something. And I must get out of this house. I'll try just one of them to start with.
Alice ate one of the little cakes and soon found herself to be a little smaller. She ate another and another until at last she was just the right size to run out of the bedroom and out of the house.
Look, there she is.
Get her!
Catch her!
But Alice was too fast for them. She ran far away from the white rabbit's house, deeper and deeper into the forest, until she became quite lost. She was wondering what she could eat or drink to make her grow to the right size again, when suddenly she saw in front of her a large mushroom, about the same size as herself, with a large blue caterpillar sitting on top of it, smoking a pipe, and taking no notice of Alice at all. Will the caterpillar help Alice to grow again? I'll tell you next time.